Hello friends, welcome. Here we are out today in Hoffman Park. Got the two cameras set up just to show you, test out what it's like on two cameras. It'll be interesting. So I thought I'd talk about calming the mind. So, you know, it's nice to come out in the countryside. It's very peaceful vibration. Even if you can just sit in your garden or around flowers, sometimes in your home, they give off an emanation of peace and a quiet and tranquil vibration. So, you know, it's nice if you're trying to meditate, any kind of meditation, to try and still the mind and quieten the mind, because we sit and we meditate and our mind keeps getting distracted, and it can take several months to learn how to quiet your mind for meditation, especially if you want to link up and connect with spirit guides or angels or whatever form you like to connect with. You've got to still your mind so that you can hear their thoughts. But in ordinary meditation, it's a good thing to do too, to still the mind. Because you sit there and you begin to meditate and it's all going well, and then you suddenly find yourself, you know, your subconscious mind, it never stops thinking. You can't completely quieten it, but fairly much so you can. And, you know, it starts drifting off and you're thinking about what you've got to do for shopping tomorrow when you're going to get the groceries or different things like that. So you can find your mind drifts on, or you're thinking about, you know, what time you've got to make lunch for a partner for tomorrow's work, or all kinds of different things. You can start having these tangents where you're drifting off in your subconscious mind. So the important thing is to, you know, just focus on something that distracts you for a little while until you can be still in the mind. So focusing on a candle is great, but you've got to have your eyes open for that, of course. So to begin with, to focus on a candle and enter into meditation is a great way of making your conscious mind go to sleep and let the subconscious have its freedom. Or a shiny object like a crystal is good as well, so you can still the mind that way. The other ways are, you know, counting backwards from a high number. It's very boring for the conscious mind. It goes to sleep quite quickly, again lets the subconscious mind have its freedom to roam. But what I personally find is just helping yourself to relax and, you know, sit back or lay down, be comfortable, and just take a deep breath in all the way into the pit of your stomach and just let it out, and breathing. And you can breathe in through your nose so you feel your in-breath, and breathe out through your nose so you feel your out-breath, or mix it however you want to. Breathe in through your mouth, then breathe out through your nose, and feel that breath leaving your body, finding yourself with each breath, taking in positive energy and breathing out all your daily cares and worries, and breathing in positive energy and then letting all your body and your mind begin to relax. So breathing is a great way to get into that relaxed state whereby, you know, you're not conscious of what's going on around you, because you lose focus on your surroundings, the room or place you're in. Could be even a train some people meditate on. I mean, it's very distracting, but they do manage to meditate on a train, some people. So you do what's good for you. You find the way that calms you down, and it's ever going into that more relaxed and more calm state where you lose focus not just on the room about you, but your own body, and you begin to drift and, you know, float around in your own subconscious mind, and the imagination begins to activate in your subconscious where it's free to roam. And, you know, that's good for just asking for healing. So you can ask for healing from God or the universe or spirit, angels or guides. You can ask for a healing, and just go into a meditation for a healing. Being relaxed means you receive a great deal more healing than feeling tense. So it's great for healing too. But you can then link up into spirit once you've got into that peaceful state. You open your chakra system up. You can start from the crown or the root at the base of your spine, and you can work your way all the way up through your chakras, which there's the base root chakra at the bottom of your spine in your pelvis. And then you've got the sacral chakra, which is orange, which is the sexuality. I mean, the root chakra is the earth connection, and the sacral chakra is a reproduction and sexual chakra, the solar plexus chakra, just above your navel inside you again, just below your rib cage. Very big chakra, a very powerful chakra, very greatly used by most of us, although we don't know it, for intuition and such like. You know, we get gut feelings, don't we? And it is that chakra that picks those psychic feelings up. So then you've got your heart chakra, of course, love and compassion, all those different things inside your chest. That's green. The solar plexus is yellow. The throat chakra, your voice box. Now, spirit can use your throat chakra and take over your voice, and you can be speaking in a foreign accent. So it's quite amazing. And then you've got your brow chakra for your third eye, your psychic eye inside your mind, where spirit can put images in there, you know, different things. And then you've got your crown, higher self chakra above your aura. That can, you know, open that, and it's opening the link to the higher self. It's opening the link to the higher vibration where spiritual communication becomes possible, but it takes all those chakras to communicate with spirit, you know, so open them all, because they'd use different chakras themselves when they're working with you. When you do meditate, you feel pressure on top of your head, and that's then putting energy into your chakra to develop them. There are other chakra around our body, and even within our mind, other chakra that do different things. So, but they are all psychic perception centers and spiritual perception centers. The more you open them up, the more you perceive spirit, because you're like an aerial spiritually, going out there and feeling all these different things. So it's great to do, but it's very important to protect yourself at the beginning of a meditation. And you know, you see a light come down from above through your crown chakra, all your chakras, it goes down through, all the way down to your feet, of light, protective light, and it fills you up like a bottle, and then overflows out the top of your head into your aura, all the way out into your, beyond your aura. And you know, that'll keep negativity away to some extent. It's never 100% safe, but it keep a great deal of negativity away from you. So that's a good thing to always do. Now, when you finish your meditation, you absolutely must. You leave that light there because it'll dissipate in its own time, but you absolutely must close each of those chakras down one at a time, seeing them going from bright, a bright light or ball or open window, different things people see them as, back to a normal state, dulling them down. And then, you know, closing your spirit down as a being of light, seeing it go a bit dimmer. Never fully close the chakra or the spiritual energy light, because we've got a light body. So you just do these things, and it protects you. Because if you leave yourself open to, after you've meditated, you can go down the supermarket, you'll be picking up everybody's feelings, and you end up having to run out of the store because you got so overloaded with the people's emotions, good feelings, bad feelings, all sorts. And you're also open to any spirit that happens to want to communicate to you that you might not want to. So important to do that. So we'll go through that process just very quickly of doing that, and then we have a little short meditation just for a couple of minutes. So just breathe in and breathe out. So this meditation is merely about stilling your mind. So you breathe in and just let all your daily worries and cares just float away, and you make a connection through your feet to the Mother Earth, to the Earth, just letting all your negative energy, and it doesn't let anything of your spirit go, but it just lets your negative energy ground to the Earth, and you let all your worries, all your tensions, all your stresses, all your negativities just flow down from your mind and body, down your feet, into the earth. And you can see roots growing from your feet down into the earth, just forming that connection, letting that negativity go. And the Mother Earth, the Earth, will replenish that energy, and you know, it'll go back into use somewhere else as positive energy. So you can draw up the terracotta brown energies of the earth to invigorate you and make you feel good. So it's just about, you know, deep breathing at the moment, breathing in and out deeply, and just letting yourself relax with each out breath, and breathing in positivity with each in breath, and just relaxing and finding yourself calming down. So we just calm ourselves down now. Now you should have finished grounding, you just draw those roots back up into yourself again. We just begin to harmonize with the world about us, the planet, the universe, the spirit realm beyond. We let our spirit vibration rise up and harmonize. And our mind begins to sink slowly into a more dormant state, a more peaceful, quiet, and tranquil state, where our subconscious begins to wander and imagine different things. We just find ourselves coming into a very peaceful state. And the mind begins to still and quiet. It stops racing, the cogs stop turning. We let our subconscious go to sleep and we begin to let our subconscious roam like in a daydream state. And that's the perfect state for meditation and relaxation. But it is also the perfect state for communicating with spirit. And if we were at this time to communicate with spirit, we'd invite them now, once our mind is quiet, to come to us and let themselves be known to us in the ways that they do. And these things can take a long time to develop. You can feel tingling and energies and pressures and itches and all kinds of things. Even your hair, when their energy goes over us, can make our hair stand on end, or you feel goosebumps when their energy go around our skin. So there's many different things you might feel and sensations when spirit come to work with us. So we're just stilling our mind this time though. If at a later point you want to go on and meditate, I have some meditations for connecting with spirit guides or angels. So we just listen to the noises around us. We can hear the birds. So we become more aware, even though we become more silent. But it doesn't distract us. But we can hear the birds in the background. And it's nature being peaceful, going about its daily business. We just relax and really let go. Just let ourselves go deeper and deeper into a more relaxed state of being. We breathe in deeply and we breathe out and relax. We feel very harmonized and at peace with the world and all things about us. And our minds becoming quiet. We just refocus on our breathing if we start to wander to different things, because we want to focus on just being peaceful, quiet, tranquil and relaxed. Going deeper and deeper into our meditation. Just allowing our mind to empty and be still. We lose focus and just let our mind and our subconscious begin to drift. This is highly beneficial for our life, because we find our stress leaves and our worries and cares all leave. And we're at peace with ourselves. And at peace with our spirit. Now we begin to come round. We're going to close this meditation now. We just see our chakras closing down, from the crown chakra down, all closing, our spirit dimming. We begin to come around, back to consciousness. And that's it, friends. That's how to enter into a meditation. We close the chakras down at the end, close the spirit down so we don't walk around open, because we don't want to be picking up bad spirit. We don't want to be picking up other people's emotions. So, you know, that's how to get into that tranquil state and let your mind just float and, you know, flow, and let your imagination have its daydream-like state, and to still the mind, to be quiet and refocus if you start thinking about different things. And, you know, then when you're ready, you know, invite a spirit guide if you want to, or an angel to work with you. Let them work with you. It takes time. You will feel sensations around you after the first few times. You'll start to feel maybe tingling and itching and stuff. You feel pressure on top of your head. It can give you a little headache sometimes. But they're just trying to power you up and open you up so that you can perceive them. So that's it for today, friends. I hope you enjoyed that. Love and light. Neil.